Hey everyone, it's Rachel back again with another reaction video, and today I'm excited because To The Grave has put out a new track. It's called Rec, but I think it's short for record based off of like the little dot next to it. It's off an album called Epilogue, which will be dropping at the end of April this year. I'm stoked because I did a reaction for Miserable Summer, and I've done I think one or two other To The Grave reactions. I know I found them through my YouTube channel last year though, but Miserable Summer has definitely been my favorite To The Grave song that I've found to date. I've went through and listen to their older material, but that song just hits a lot differently. There's a million things about it that I really dig, but since I did the reaction video, I definitely have grown to love it even more now than I did when I initially heard it. So I'm stoked. I think that this album will be awesome. It has a ton of songs on it. I know that a decent amount of them have already been released, but it's still a 19-track album, which will be awesome. So I'm gonna stop talking and we are gonna get straight into it. See, that's what it looks like. Record. To The Grave, Wreck, or Record, let's discuss. I'm gonna be ready for this album when it drops. Obviously, with this big of an album, I can't do an album reaction. But for me, other than Darko, which I would consider to be my favorite deathcore band, Brand of Sacrifice and To The Grave are really coming up there for me, especially with Miserable Summer. That song really opened me up to The Grave and going through their older material, which is also very awesome. I dig it, but this newer stuff that they're putting out is different to me. It grabs me much more, and I talk about that a lot on my channel. Like looking for something to grab me, because I listen to a ton of music. I do a lot of requests. I personally like to listen to a lot of music. So when I'm listening to new music, I'm looking for something to make it stick out to me, to sound a bit different, to make me wanna, so it will stick out to me as something like, oh, you know what I wanna listen to? Oh, you know what I should add to this playlist or what I should put on? And I do think that To The Grave has that. And there are a number of reasons for that, which obviously I'm about to talk about. But first of all, the vocals are phenomenal. For me, I felt like at first, like, I had a hard time getting into deathcore as much because for me, a lot of the vocals, I think it was just the bands that I was trying to get into it with. Like, I hadn't heard Tom Barber before from Chelsea Grin. Chelsea Grin is definitely up there with Tom Barber as well. He's just one of my favorite deathcore vocalists in general. But anyway, regarding To the Grave, so for me, those vocals are really on point. And what I was saying was when I was first trying to get into deathcore, the bands I was trying and stuff, the vocals just they all sounded somewhat similar and like they were trying to kind of accomplish the same thing. And I just wasn't, that's what I thought. I was like, well, I don't know, maybe it's just like the style of vocal that's used in deathcore. But that's definitely not the case after listening to the Grave, after listening to Brand of Sacrifice, after listening to Tom Barber and Darko and Chelsea Grin, stuff like that. I know that's not the case. And also with To the Grave, you get stuff like the atmosphere in the songs. Like, for example, the lead up to the last breakdown that we get, which was fantastic and so brutal, by the way. Great way to end the song like that. But the lead up to it, you've got like the instrumental emphasis, and then you've got like it stops and you've got this pause where there's sort of like this airy, eerie almost feeling before that last breakdown hits. And I think that's the case in Miserable Summer. A lot of the To the Grave songs that I've listened to, there's those additions in the ambiance of the song as well as the vocals. Also, the bassist screams on here were on point as well. I guess the only thing, I try to like give something that I would want to see done differently on this song, but it's hard with stuff like this, as I say, when I like it so much on first listen and I'm like, yep, this is gonna go on repeat for me, especially with deathcore. I think I've said that a number of times because for me, like I said, deathcore has been something that I've slowly, definitely at a much more accelerated pace now, but at first it was something, before I had my channel, I was slowly getting into, and I didn't really know that much about it, so I'm still learning what I like with deathcore. The vocal range on Dane is definitely impressive. There's just something about both of, because normally I feel like for me, I'm like, oh, I prefer this vocalist's highs over their lows or something like that. But with his vocals, I feel like they are both incredibly on point. And yeah, I'm stoked on this. I'm stoked on the album because, like I said, I still think Miserable Summer is my favorite song from To the Grave. This is really awesome, but there's just something about that, like, Nowhere to Run part and like the like I was talking about, there's, that song is just huge. It's got so much going on in the mood, like the ambiance brings like the mood to the song, obviously, is what I feel. And I feel like in that song it's just nailed down perfectly. And then yeah, there's so many reasons, but this is obviously not a video about that song. Anywho, those are my thoughts on this track. Let me know what you thought in the comments, and if you have a different song that you'd like to see added to either of the lists that I work off of when I'm doing my request-based videos, both links will be in the description, as well as the invite link for the Discord server, which will be in the Linktree link, actually. The Discord server, I talk about it quite a bit. We've got a ton of members in there, a ton of channels, a lot of fun conversations. So if you're kind, you like online communities and Discord, feel free to join. Also, in that Linktree link in the description, you'll find the link for my Instagram profile. My handle on there is Rachel Reacts, just like my YouTube channel, but I will throw it up here on the screen for you, as well as, you know, where you can find it in the description. I post my music collection, so like vinyl, flags, shirts, sweatshirts, all merch stuff like that, what I'm listening to the most each week, new songs that I find, that sort of thing. So if you have any interest, feel free to give me a follow. And as always, thank you very much for watching. I appreciate it.